Gloria in excelsis Deo. Dominus vobis
et tuo spiritu
tuo. Oremus. Deus qui per immaculatam virginis conceptionem dignium filio tuo habitaculum preparasti, quae sumus ut qui ex morte iusdem filii tui brevisam, eam ab omni labe preservasti nos quoque mundus eius intercessione ad te pervenire concedas. Per eundem Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus. Egescit ad Domine corda nostra ad preparandas unigeniti tui vias, ut per eius adventum purificatis tibi menetibus servire mere amur, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Dominus possedit me in initio vitam sua.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear community members, and dear brethren, the feast of the Immaculate Conception is very dear to all of us as members of the Institute of Christ the King, Sovereign Priest. In our seminary in Italy, we prepare it for it with a solemn novena. I must tell you that this is among my most beautiful souvenirs as a seminarian. The novena to the Immaculate Conception with all the candles, the daily sermon, daily benediction, and that includes the beautiful singing of the hymn Tota Pulchra es Maria. Wherever our community is established around the world, we also prepare this feast with great solemnity, being united with all those who attend the ceremonies. Today, we are united in a special way with our Prior General, Monseigneur Gilles Vac, who is going to renew solemnly, with a great solemnity, the consecration of the Institute of Christ the King and of all the members to the Immaculate Conception. After Holy Mass tonight, I will also renew this consecration in your presence. Tonight, my dear brethren, we have a special prayer intention. We especially pray for the repose of the soul of Mrs. Rose Barrett, Rose, who was called to eternal life last Thursday. Her funeral will be celebrated tomorrow at 11 a.m. Rose was very well known to all of us here in Limerick. She was only 54 years old, and we all know how involved she was in all the events and the activities of the church. So we have a grave duty to pray for her, pray for the family. My dear brethren, I'm sure that you certainly meet from time to time some people who, let us say, see the evil one everywhere. Whenever they commit a sin, they claim the evil one to be responsible for it. Whenever they have a sore somewhere in their body, they say, that's the evil one who is attacking me. I am under great attack. So they jump to the church, and they ask the priest for a quick blessing. Sometimes it can be true, but most of the time it's certainly an exaggeration. The evil one is not everywhere. Nevertheless, it's absolutely certain that the evil one shows its mark upon all of all physical creation, plants, animals, and also human beings. Just yesterday we had this big storm. How can we not see even the evil one in action in the weather? The existence of sin in the world is represented in Holy Scripture by the serpent. It is indeed the serpent that first appeared in the Garden of Eden, a symbol of pride and desire to be like the Most High. It is the serpent again who appeared to Eve as an angel of light. We may remember in the book of Genesis that Adam is described as being placed at the head of humanity, so that when he sinned, the rest of the body, his children, and all the rest of physical creation suffered also. All of creation feels this loss. The whole world now experiences the consequences of that original sin: death, suffering, ignorance, sickness. Right up to this very moment, a great disorder has settled in the world. Right up to this very moment, all creatures have rebelled against their head. All humankind has rebelled against God. But at the same time, we all long for God to restore that which was lost. We all long for the coming of Jesus, who is the only one who can free us from all evils through the shedding of his blood. Today, my dear brethren, we admire and we accept We invite within our souls God's plans, God's desire, God's grace, God who preserves one creature from all mankind, all kinds of disorder, the Blessed Virgin Mary, who crushed the head of the serpent. She is the only one physical creature that has been preserved from all this evil. In Mary's heart, there has never been any kind of sin. There was never any rebellion, but only purity, only beauty, only innocence, since her conception in the womb of her mother, Saint Anne. This privilege and grace is expressed in the encyclical published by Blessed Pope Pius IX in 1854 in these words. We declare, pronounce, and define that the doctrine which holds that the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, in the first instance of her conception, by a singular grace and privilege granted by Almighty God, in view of the merits of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the human race, was preserved from all stain of original sin, is a doctrine revealed by God, and therefore to be believed firmly and constantly by all the faithful. During our formation in our seminary in Italy, we read the whole encyclical Ineffabilis Deus every year. It's a masterpiece. It's something great for our formation, for a real food for our soul, for our spiritual life, that really encourage us to pray to Our Lady, but always rooted in the Catholic dogma, the Immaculate Conception. This article of our faith is also expressed in many different ways, and one of the beautiful ones is the hymn that we have been singing throughout the Novena, Tota Pulchra Es Maria. Please pay a special attention tonight while singing with your whole heart these words, Tota Pulchra Es Maria, Thou art all fair, O Mary. And then, Et macula non est in te, and no stain is in thee. This is the heart of the feast. It's how this feast could be just resumed, just defined in a few words. My dear brethren, you know that Our Lady likes France very much. She visited France so many times. And one of the times was in 1830, when she appeared to Saint Catherine Labouret in Paris. She invited her to come up to her, closer to her. And this is an invitation for all of us as well, to be close to Mary, close to her immaculate heart, close to the purest heart of all times. She was invited to kneel down in her presence, next to Our Lady. And then she gave Catherine a message for herself and the entire world. Come to the foot of this altar. There, graces will be poured out for all who ask for them. You see, my dear brethren and dear friends, we must ask for the intercession of Our Lady, for her presence. We must ask for this special grace of never forget that we can live close to her. We must have this holy life, this pure life, this beautiful life at her imitation, imitating each one of her virtue, and always receive her protection. As a conclusion, let me just quote the hymn that we have also been singing throughout the Novena at the end of each ceremony. It is a kind of a spiritual program. It's special resolutions that we have to renew within our hearts, and so that we can really follow the Immaculate Heart of Mary, the one who will protect us from all the evils of these terrible times for the world and for the Church. Let us ask Our Lady Immaculate to be children chaste and mild, who always turn their hearts to Thee, Let us always live piously under the Queen's of Purity's virginal mantle. In thee we find our rest. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum et Deum.
Thank you. Thank you. domenia secula seculo. Dominus vobis cum. Sursum corda. Gratia sagamus Domino Deo nostro. Vere dignum et justo cum est, et cum est salutare. Nos tibi serem per et ubique gratia sagere. Domine sancte pater omnipotens et erene Deus, et te in conceptione immaculate, variate Marie semper virginis cum laudare. Benedicere et predicare. Qui et unigenitum tuum Sancti Spiritus omnium ratione concepit, et virginitatis gloria permanente lumen aeternum mundo effudit. Iesum Christum Dominum nostrum. Per quem majestatem tuam laudarent angeli, adorant dominationes, tremunt potes tates. Celice lorum quae virtut est, ac beata Seraphim, socia exultatione concelebrant. Cum quibus et nostras voces, ut admiti iubeas deprecamur, supplici confessione, dicentes. Romania secula seculorum. Receptis salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimite nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Romania secula seculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobis.
Dio te omnipotenti, beati Maria semper virgi, beato Michele Arcangel, beato Ioanne Baptiste, sanctis apostolis Petro et Paolo, omnibus sanctis et tibi pater, quia peccavi nimis cogitatione verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Idio preco beata Mariam semper virgin, beatum Michaelum Arcangel, beatum Ioannem Baptista, sanctus apostolus Petrum et Paulum, omnes sanctos et te pater. Orari pro mea Dominum Deum nostrum.
Miseria tu vesti omnipotens Deus, et dimitis et peccatis vestris, perducat vos et vitam aeternam.
Amen.
Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, tribuat vobis omnipotens et misericorde Dominus.
Amen.
Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi. Domine non sum dignus, et tectum eum, sed tantum in verbo et in agitur animalia. Domine non sum dignus, et tectum eum, sed tantum in verbo et in agitur animalia. Domine non sum dignus, et tectum eum, sed tantum in verbo et in agitur animalia.
Thank you.
Dominus vobis.
Oremus. Sacramenta que sum simus Domine Deus noster, ilius in nobis culpe vulnerare parent, aqua immaculatam beati Mariae conceptionem singulariter preservasti. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus. Repleti cibo spiritualis animonie supplices te Domine de precamur, ut uius participatione misteri, doceas nos terrena despicere et amare celestia. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dominus vobis.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Thank you.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe exaudinus,
Christe exaudinus,
Pater de celis et Deus,
miserere tuus,
Filii redemptor munet ideus,
miserere tuus,
Spiritus et sanget et Deus,
miserere tuus,
Sancta Trinitas unus Deus, Sanget Maria, Sanget Dei Genitris, Sanget Virgo Virginum, Marte Christi, Mater Ecclesiae. Mater divine gratiae, Mater purissima, Mater castissima, Mater inviolata, Mater intemerata. Mater amabilis,
ora pro nobis.
Mater admirabilis,
ora pro nobis.
Mater boni consilii,
ora pro nobis.
Mater creatoris,
ora pro nobis.
Mater salvatoris. Virgo prudentissima, Virgo veneranda, Virgo predicanda, Virgo potens, Virgo clemens. Virgo fidelis, speculum justitiae, sedes sapientiae, causa nostrae letitiae. Vase spirituale, vase honorabile, vase insigne devotionis, pro rosa mystica, turris et davidica, Turris et Bornea, Doromus Aurea, Federis Arca, Iano Aceli, Stella Matutina,